Hey guys, what's up? We're having a look at the 2020 McLaren 720S Spider. If you're new to the channel, I'm Brian Makse, accomplished racing driver. Have reviewed the coupe version of this, and you can check the link here below and on our channel. And that thing was something else. This particular car I'm testing near home, which is near Toronto, and the roads outside of the city all across this province are pretty much crap. They're not like the roads you're going to see in our 720 coupe video. So let's go for a bit of a drive in this 2020 McLaren 720S Spider. Straight off the top, there are a couple of differences, and one of the first things is the front axle lift. I don't think the button was here on the old coupe that I drove. I think it was on this steering column stock on the left side, and you had to dig in through a menu to do that. This is really easy. Just press the button, raises up, press the button, slow, lowers, but it's also very slow, and that's another story, but you know, it still serves the appropriate function. As well, on the leading edge of the doors, in that scalloped area in the middle of the door, there's actually a grate that stops, you know, dirt, gravel, stones, and all sorts of things from traveling into that space in the door from the wheel well. And that's actually a good thing, because on the coupe, it would fill with gravel at low speeds, high speeds, all sorts of things. So neat to see that that grate there, and it certainly has a little bit of extra function. If you don't know about these crazy McLarens, well, one of the coolest things is that the tub is entirely carbon fiber. And that gives this car unmatched rigidity. And even as a Spider, the chassis just seems as rigid as the coupe. Although you lose the drama of the door being part of the roof, and you know, that's how it goes. But as far as its performance goes, there's little difference between this and the coupe. And in fact, I was teaching at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park this week, and there was a gentleman there in a 720S coupe, and he was killing it. Probably the fastest car on track that day. And that speaks to how easy this car is to drive. And speaking of which, seating position is excellent. View out the front is excellent. Of course, this is a mid-engine car, so the cowl is low. You get a nice view at the front. But what McLaren does is they don't throw any buttons on the steering wheel, just the shift paddles, that's it. They create a very straightforward driver interface, a little different than their Formula One cars or their GT4, GT3 race cars, but it still gives you a sense of occasion that you are driving something that does demand your attention. And as it should. I mean, this thing is 700 horsepower, so you should. And it is so quick that you really do need to pay attention. And it's also, you know, with, for example, the brake pedal pressure, you'd really need to get into that brake pedal. Well, it takes a lot of pressure to actuate the brakes, and they're carbon ceramics, of course, but there's a bit of additional pedal pressure there that's required, and that's really a good thing, especially when you're going fast or driving the 720 on the track. But feel and modulation is excellent as well. But I just love the steering. Yeah, we're driving on a straight road, but I love how direct, how light, and how much feedback I get from the steering wheel. The pedal box is very narrow, and this is one of the few occasions with a road car where you probably want driving shoes. For most manuals, for example, I advocate skate shoes and live and die by my Vans skate shoes. But in this case, the pedal box and the pedals are so close together that you probably do want a pair of driving shoes. But overall, as a handling package, you can place this McLaren with ridiculous precision at any speed. It is just brilliant, and I love that character about this car. There's no masking it, there's no hiding it. It is absolutely a brilliant driving car. And speaking of which, McLaren's, you know, very cool, very trick, and also very heavy suspension system. It works very well. If we switch over to track mode, the ride comfort is much the same, but we can switch back to just comfort mode, and this cruises as comfortably as you know, any Mercedes-Benz S-Class. Like all supercars, there is just about zero cabin storage. Yes, the boot or the front trunk is cavernous in this case, much more space than a Lamborghini Huracan, by the way. You can throw all sorts of stuff in there. I've got two bags and a tripod in there right now, and there's more than enough space. I could throw another bag in there and probably a case of wine, who knows. But there's tons of storage up there, there's just about nothing inside. There's a little bit of space here. There's two cup holders. There's a spot maybe for your tiny mobile phone. And there's this little pouch here, and that's all you got. So do understand that this is a wee bit compromised for something you're gonna drive a little more frequently than once a week. Here's one of the things about this 720S that creates a bit of a ritual when you start up. Of course, there's the start button, and I like setting the powertrain to track mode, handling to comfort, and what that means is when I hit the active button, the screen rolls down into this, you know, narrow display, as you've seen, and I've also got to hit that button to raise the screen up, because I prefer the big screen. I don't really appreciate this motorized device, especially when so much effort and time has gone into making this car lighter. I don't understand why there's electric motors here, but hey, that's just me. What I love about the Spider is that it really changes the character of the 720. The coupe is a little bit buttoned down, and sure, with a glass, you've got, you know, almost a 360 degree view. And what they've done here, though, is those sort of C pillars, those buttresses are now transparent, so you can actually see through them. Helps a little bit from time to time, but of course there are parking sensors and 360 degree cameras, so you can park this with a little bit of ease. On the other hand, when you're in traffic and you come to a stop, what you often find is there's just a wave of heat that rolls in from the engine cover into the cabin. Unless you've got the fans blowing at high speed, that wave of heat is just going to fall into this cabin. And in the summertime, like when I'm driving, you really don't want that extra heat. But on the other hand, you do get to hear that fantastic 4-liter twin turbo V8. I don't know if you could see it in this clip, but when you get into the brake pedal, just like the 720 coupe, that rear wing deploys vertically to act as a bit of an air brake, and you know that's great. Otherwise, it sits tight with the body and only activates when you need it, which is very infrequently on the road. On the racetrack, that's a different story, but you know, if you have to raise your wing and drive around with that, there's something wrong with you. There's no need for that. Especially in a car as high-tech as this. The wing only activates when you need it, and I love that about this car. One of the things I love about McLaren V8s is that they sound like more like a superbike than a supercar, and that makes them distinct, certainly, in addition to McLaren styling, but it really sounds like a bike more so than a car, and that's one of the things I love about McLaren. One of the things about driving a supercar is that it does get a lot of attention, and while I've had this for the last few days, I've left it under wraps, mostly because I've been busy, but I really don't want to talk to people because I'm just busy and I have other things to do. But when you do bring it out, people want to talk, so you have to appreciate that if you're driving this thing, someone's at least going to give you the thumbs up, and at worst, they want you to stop and talk about the car. And if you're okay with that, well, that's great. But there are some days where I just don't want to talk to people, and I have on occasion just left this in my garage. Now, I'd love to have this on some great roads, but those don't exist in this part of the world, and you know that means going to the racetrack, which I do. I just haven't done it with this car, and I don't think they'd let me either, but that's another story. But yeah, at some point I'd like to explore a 720 a little further, and I do like open air cars. I do have a preference for them, and this one, you know, it acts like both a gotta love that, both a Spider and a convertible. Let's get the speed down here. And one of the things I have to demonstrate is how quickly this roof mechanism works. It takes no time at all to close. And you know, if you got caught in the rain, this would be absolutely perfect. You'd have that roof up before you got wet. With the roof up, though, it's not quite the same thing. It's not quite the same experience. Very much like the coupe, but you know, this transparent roof with this trick panel of glass is pretty neat. You know, if I were looking at one of these, I'd probably go for the Spider, just because I like the option of having the occasion for open air motoring, and that really changes the character of the car. So let's do this again. We'll slow down to the appropriate speed. Here we go. Throw the roof down, and in no time at all, look at this. We are now a Spider. Gotta love it. Well done, McLaren, on that roof mechanism. That's the quickest I've seen in a very, very long time, and very easy to use as well. There's no need to talk about the styling. Either you like it or you don't. I think McLaren's design language is very distinct, and you know, everybody who knows supercars knows that this is a McLaren. There's no confusing it for anything else, and that's what I like about it. There's a lot of functional design that's gone into this 720, which we talked about in the coupe review a couple of years ago. But if you examine it carefully, you can see how the air is moved around the car, how it's channeled through the car, and that is so cool. It's ridiculous. And I love that aspect about McLarens, that they're very, very functional first and foremost. I will speak to McLaren's infotainment system, and yes, it's nice and it works well and all of that stuff, and you know, you can navigate around it fairly easily, but it is not the quickest, and it doesn't have Apple CarPlay, which is significant. The last thing I want to do is mount my phone here on the glass or the dashboard. Mechanical grip and balance is just excellent. Just gotta love that. And with the top down, you really get to hear that engine. Even, you know, at highway speeds, click it up to top gear, we're cruising along. You can have a conversation, but I just like having the option of open air motoring. And, you know, as an open car, or at least having the option of having the roof down, there really aren't any compromises. It acts much like the coupe with the roof up, and you get to enjoy driving with the top down. And you know, to me, that's that enhances the driving experience, and I absolutely love it. If you're gonna ask me, well, I think the Spider is the choice. It acts nearly like the coupe, but you have the option of driving with the top down. And as a convertible, as a Spider, it's very, very competent and does everything you want as an open air supercar. It's quite enjoyable. Still not perfect, but you know what the shortcomings are. We've reviewed those, and you know, if this is your jam, you gotta try one of these. It's absolutely fantastic and very, very compelling. Thanks for hanging out with us today and having a look at this McLaren 720S Spider. Hope you liked it. If you did, be sure to click like, share, and subscribe. And as always, we want to know what you think, so please leave a comment below, and I'll do my best to respond to those comments when I get a chance. As well, if you really did like this piece, well, hit up our merch store. The link is here, link is below. There's lots of cool stuff there. And if you really did like what we've done, well, you know, we're making pennies on YouTube, so hit up our Patreon if that's your thing. Anyway, thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. Hi.
Thank you.
Yeah. Everybody wants to be my friend.